was a wild high-speed chase with two vehicles screaming down a 10-mile stretch of a very busy highway, and all of it fueled by out-of-control road rage. Other drivers on the road were making panicked calls to 911. And ABC's Lindsay Janis is here now with more on how this whole thing ended. Good morning.
Good morning, guys. Just imagine going down the highway with two cars not just chasing each other, weaving in and out of traffic, but also ramming each other at up to 100 miles an hour.
This twisted pile of metal is the result of what authorities are calling an extreme case of road rage. The first 911 call coming in at 6:37 p.m. on Wednesday night.
There's two cars that look like road rage. They went crazy.
The caller reporting two cars driving dangerously on Washington State's Interstate 90 near the city of Issaquah.
And one of them just, pardon me?
One of them just what?
Just hit the other one.
The two speeding SUVs begin slamming into each other multiple times as if trying to run each other off the road.
Both of them are extremely dangerous.
The terrifying scene playing out for 10 miles, endangering everyone on that road. More than a dozen 911 calls came in.
I have no idea what the hell they were doing. They almost hit me. They were chasing each other. One was obviously trying to follow the other extremely closely. They were weaving in and out of traffic.
Then this.
They just hit each other. They were merging in the same lane.
A final collision. The two SUVs flipping over, left mangled in the center median in the town of Bellevue. Police say 29-year-old Desi Beltran was driving this Ford Explorer, and inside this Ford Freestyle, 32-year-old Hugo Yanez. Yanez had two passengers, a 27-year-old woman said to be Beltran's ex-girlfriend and her 2-year-old son.
It's remarkable, and it's a testimony to the increasing safety features of vehicles that all the occupants were okay.
Both drivers were treated for minor injuries and arrested. The cars totaled and towed away. Yanez tried to flee the scene, but was quickly tracked down by police.
Well, police now believe the incident was sparked by a domestic dispute. Both men were in court on Friday to face a judge. Yanez charged with reckless driving, reckless endangerment, and two counts of hit and run. His bail set at $20,000. Beltran was charged with a count of felony domestic violence assault. His bail set at $1 million.
And a 2-year-old in the car.
That's shocking.
A 2-year-old in one of the cars.
Yeah.
Really shocking.
All right, Lindsay, thank you.